What's up, geeks, and welcome to the channel. While implementing binary search trees, red-black trees, AVL trees, or any other type of tree in our data structures and tree series, we always used to mention three main traversal techniques we usually make use of: the in-order, pre-order, and post-order traversal. Now, if you remember, when we traverse a binary search tree in an in-order manner, we visit the left child first, then its parent or the root of the subtree, then the right child. And traversing the nodes this way will output them in ascending order, or in other words, the data stored inside the nodes of this tree will be returned to us but sorted. So, given an array or list, we can decide to create a binary search tree from the elements of that list, and then sort them by traversing the tree we created in an in-order manner. This sorting technique goes by tree sort, and it's the subject of today's quick video. Okay, we've already discussed in detail and implemented both the insertion and the in-order traversal of a binary search tree in a previous video, so I'm not going to dwell a lot on the explanation. I'll just do a quick recap and then jump right into the implementation. Let's take this array of integers for example. The first step is to create a binary search tree using that array. This can be done by going through every element of the array and inserting it into our tree. Then all we have to do is traverse the tree we created in an in-order manner by going left, middle, right, and the results we'll obtain are the same elements we started with but sorted. Now, concerning the implementation, we're going to cover both the recursive and the iterative approach, so let's get to it. And let's start with the recursive one. Here I'll just drop the insert and traverse code we implemented on several occasions, in which we output to the console the data stored in the tree node. Feel free to check our recursion with trees video, where we explain how these recursive methods work exactly and how each line of code was deduced. Now, the sort method we created inside the tree sort class will just reuse everything we previously implemented, as you can see. The main difference between this method and the classic BST implementation is that this one will take a list of the elements we want as input and will insert them into a created binary search tree before running the traversal logic. All we care about is sort a list of elements given to us. How we do it in the back end, it's not the user's concern. As you can see, if we want to make use of this logic, we will create an instance of the tree sort class and call the sort method by providing it with a list of elements. There is no mention of the binary search tree we are creating at all on the client side. You can also use the second variation of the traversal code that returns a list of the sorted elements instead of just printing them to the console. Remember, the insertion and traversal code are inside the binary search tree class, and we are creating an instance of this class in the tree sort logic we just wrote. Okay, for the second part of this video, we're going to implement the in-order traversal method in an iterative way, as we previously didn't have the chance to do that. But before we jump into the code, let's take this tree as an example. And because the recursive approach uses the memory stack, here we'll need to create a stack of our own. The first step the iterative approach takes is add the leftmost nodes of the tree, starting from the root, to the stack we created. Now that the top of the stack points to the smallest node of the tree, we pop it from the stack along with its parent to add them to our sorted list, and then check if its right child has a branch of its own, in other words, if it has children. In this case, it doesn't, so we push it and pop it directly from the stack to add it to our sorted list, and go up in the tree. Now we are back at the root, so after popping it, and similarly to what we just did, we try to visit its right child and realize that it indeed has children of its own. So we go again to the far left and repeat the same logic on the subtree. Now, to implement this logic, we'll start by creating a stack and by initializing the iterating node, which, as mentioned, will start at the root. Then, while this node is not null or the stack is not empty, we need to go to the far left side of the tree, all while pushing the nodes we encountered to the stack created. Now, when we reach the smallest node, which means that the top of the stack points to the smallest element inside the tree, or the iterating current variable we have is null, we need to start popping elements from this stack. At this point, we can print them out or add them to a list, whatever you prefer. And finally, we need to check if the right child of the popped element has a subtree of its own. This is done by rerunning the whole logic on the right child of the node we popped. As you can see, if we try to call the sort method we previously implemented while using the iterative approach inside the BST implementation instead of the recursive one, we'll obtain the same sorted list as expected. So, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you guys for watching. Take care, and I will see you in the next one.